Well, we see a lot of sunshine out there, and that looks nice, but the temperatures are still on the cold side. We're finally beginning to warm up a little bit, but our low this morning was 22 degrees, so take some time to get a little bit warmer. It's 35 at the Allen County Airport. We've got 36 in Van Wert, 37 up in Ottawa, down in Wapog 34, Minster's at 34 too. We expect a high of about 40 degrees, so we'll see the temperatures warm up just a little bit more this afternoon. Let's look at the big picture and see across the nation that there's really not a lot happening, especially in the midsection where this high pressure ridge is the dominating feature. We've got lots of sunshine out there, but we expect to see more clouds by tomorrow. Zooming in closer, the difference between today and yesterday is the winds. The winds have died down a lot. They're just on the light side today, around 5 to 6 miles per hour right now. Yesterday we had strong gusty winds, and tomorrow the winds are going to pick up too, even into Thanksgiving Day. So right now it's nice to see the light winds where wind chills really aren't much of a factor. But as I said, the winds are going to kick up. Here we are Wednesday around noontime. Some wind gusts up to about 25, close to 30 miles per hour for tomorrow. Here we are 8 o'clock at night tomorrow, 30 mile per hour gust winds. This is all ahead of a cold front that's going to be moving in. We'll start to see the rain Wednesday night, and then throughout the day on Thanksgiving Day, we'll see some gusty winds. But then here by Friday, the winds begin to die down. So here's the high pressure ridge that's dominating, giving us the nice weather. Giving a lot of people nice weather from down south over into the plain states. Now it will gradually continue to move over to the mid-Atlantic states. And so tomorrow we'll start to see a little bit more of a southerly flow. Now don't get too excited about that. That only means have a high about 50 degrees, but it will be a little bit warmer air. But we'll see increasing clouds too, because by Wednesday night we'll start to see the shower activity in the overnight hours as you're sleeping. And then this cold front will be moving in. And Thanksgiving Day is starting to look a little wet. We're going to see showers moving through. Not expected to see any thunderstorms, but light to moderate rain expected as we see that cold front move through. Friday, we begin to dry up. There's a new high pressure ridge behind it, but we're on the backside of a cold front. So what does that mean? Colder temperatures, of course. But looking at Skycast, you can see how we just see extra clouds moving in for tomorrow. And then here we are looking at about 4 or 5 in the morning. Yep, we're all getting rain. Looks pretty wet out there. And that kind of rain is going to continue throughout the day on Thursday. We'll get a break by the afternoon, it looks like, and things will begin to taper off. So looking at the forecast for today, we expect to see a high about 40 degrees. So it'll warm up about 5 more degrees, but still lots of sunshine and those lighter winds out of the west. Tonight, 29 the low, so it drops down, but not as cold as we had tonight. Mostly clear skies, and those winds shift already. You can see out of the south, 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tomorrow, high 50, mostly sunny skies, but the wind's going to pick up. We could see those gusts up to 25, 30 miles an hour. Looking at the 7-day extended forecast, on Thanksgiving Day, showers throughout the day. You'll need the umbrella and raincoat, and our high only 47. Then Friday, we're going to see the sunshine return. A new high pressure ridge moves in, but look at that cold temperature. A high only 35, warms up into the lower 40s for the end of the holiday weekend. So at least nice dry weather for people heading home. So if you do have to travel, maybe think about traveling Wednesday afternoon and evening before the rain comes.
That's the key. Be strategic about when you go home. Exactly. Yeah, that's good.
All right. Well, coming up on Noon Edition, recent court cases.